everybody, it's Becky. Welcome back to my channel if you're already subscribed to me. And if you're new, thanks so much for stopping by today. I hope you'll enjoy today's video and that you'll subscribe and become part of my YouTube channel family by clicking that subscribe button down below. So you guys already know, but some of you might not, that we homeschool. This is actually finishing up our 6th year of homeschooling. So I've been doing it for a little while now, and I like to do these end of the year kind of recap videos to share with you guys the highs and lows and changes that have happened in our homeschool life over the last year. 2019-2020 school year has definitely been eventful. It started out and most of it was pretty normal, and then it just kind of exploded towards the end. So we're talking about that, and then also some changes with each girl, kind of what has happened in the last year with their homeschool. So starting with my oldest, if you don't know already, she just finished up 10th grade here at home. So I officially have had a homeschooled high schooler now for 2 years, and I'm still alive. Sophomore year, I really did have to put a lot more effort into planning her classes, making sure that she is getting really close to finishing her high school graduation requirements, but then also thinking ahead of like, what is she gonna need for college? What can she take in high school as a dual enrollment class that will count for college? And I'll talk about that a little bit later. So just a little bit more college prep, but still not crazy. The thing that intimidated me the most about homeschooling through high school is how to make a transcript. They need a transcript to graduate. They need a transcript for college, and you have to have one. And normally when you're in public school, the school system keeps that for you. You don't have to think about that as a parent. But when you are the homeschool parent and the school and the guidance counselor and the principal and the attendance clerk and the, you know, all that stuff, that's all you, and you have to be the one to know how to make a transcript. And so that scared me to death, because I was like, I have no clue how to make one. And I know it's a very important, like, official document that colleges are going to want and look at and study to see what your child has been doing for the 4 years they were in high school and what grades they got and what their GPA was and all that stuff. And I had no clue how to even figure out a GPA. So I finally quit dragging my feet with it, and I sat down one night, and it took me a few hours, but I really did a lot of research. I looked at a lot of samples online, and I made a transcript for my high schooler. And so far, like I said in a different video, she's already been accepted to 2 colleges for dual enrollment classes for junior year. So maybe they might ask for more things on that transcript later on down the road. I can't imagine what else they would need to see, because it has all the main basic information. But it has worked for us so far, and again, it's a step in the right direction. So if you guys don't know already, I'm actually offering the transcript template that I made that got her already approved into 2 colleges. I'm offering that an editable download that you can actually purchase. It's only $10. You can use it for as many kids as you want. You can make as many changes to it as you want, because it is editable, and that will save you guys a lot of time and headache, I think, just to go ahead and purchase the one that I have that's worked for us and use it for your own homeschool for your own kids. So like I said, 100% editable, make whatever changes you want, and then you can use it for all of your kids that are coming up and going to be going through high school. If you guys are interested in purchasing my editable transcript template, just to save yourself some time and headache and hassle of figuring out how to make one, or paying a service a lot more to make one for you, just email me at aplacetonest@gmail.com. And I will send you your download for you to be able to use for your kids. Because I do feel like that was a very scary thing for me to think about doing. Now that it's done, I feel a lot better about it, and I want to share it with you guys. I also had her take the ACT this past school year. Now, normally you don't take the ACT until you're a junior and or senior. But if you're going to do dual enrollment classes, meaning your child is going to take a college class in high school that will count for both, they require that they have an ACT score on file before they'll let you apply for college. So she had to go ahead and take the ACT as a sophomore, which was a little bit kind of, we were a little unsure how that was gonna turn out, just because as a sophomore, she hasn't even done some of the math skills particularly that are on the ACT, because she's not even a junior yet. But thankfully, she actually did really well. She actually beat me on the ACT score in some categories from when I was a junior in high school. She got a good enough ACT score that she was able to enroll, because they do have a minimum GPA requirement, and they do have a minimum ACT score requirement to be able to take dual enrollment classes. So thankfully she was able to at least meet or exceed in some cases what they wanted her to be able to enroll for those college classes. So which leads me to the next thing that was kind of a big deal. We did actually enroll her in her first college class that she's gonna be doing all online, but it's still a college class. It's gonna count for college, and it's gonna count for high school. So in our state, one semester of a college class equals one full year of a high school class. So she's gonna be taking English 101. That's gonna count for an entire year of high school language arts, English, whatever you wanna call it. We're not really sure yet what she's gonna do spring semester, because that's gonna be fall semester. She may take English 102 in the spring. We just really are playing it out with just this one class to see how it goes, how she's able to handle it, kind of get her a little bit of experience with a college class versus just something we do here at home. And we're gonna take it from there. So like I said earlier, you don't have to plan everything out so far in advance, because some things you just really don't know how they're gonna go. But that's kind of a big deal, like to enroll her in her first official college class as a high schooler. Speaking of language arts and English, for her language arts program in sophomore year, we did add a writing element that was new. We have never done before. If you have watched my channel for a while, the last freshman year and sophomore year, then you would know we have used the Good and the Beautiful's language arts program for her. Love it. I can't say enough good things about it. It's grammar and writing and punctuation and vocabulary and spelling and geography and art all rolled into one curriculum, and literature. But I really wanted to make sure, because we did know that she was gonna be taking a college class in high school for English. I did want to make sure that her writing was like on point. About mid-year, we added a separate writing curriculum just to make sure that her writing skills were really, really strong. And we added essentials in writing. I did a separate review video about that if you want to check it out. I definitely love the Good and the Beautiful's language arts for high school, but I do feel like if you want to just make sure that their writing skills are really super strong, I wouldn't hurt to add maybe another writing curriculum in addition to the Good and the Beautiful. So we've been doing both of those things together. And I feel like she did score really, really high on the ACT with writing and reading skills. So highly recommend the Good and the Beautiful's language arts for high school, and I highly recommend essentials in writing for writing in high school. Another big change, it actually affects both girls. We're not gonna be going back to our homeschool co-op for the 2020-2021 school year. There's quite a few reasons for that. If you guys wanna know why, you can definitely check out the video I made all about why we're not going back. I've linked it for you in the description box. Quite a few things led to that decision, but I really just feel like, as much as I hated to do it, I really feel like it was necessary, at least for this coming school year. I don't know what's gonna happen the 2021-2022 school year. We may revisit going back to that one or maybe a different co-op, but there really aren't a lot of choices in our area. So I kind of feel like I don't really know what's gonna happen in that regard. Either way, I know the girls will be fine. There are definite pros and cons to a homeschool co-op, and I talk about that more in that video as well. So if you want to hear more about that, just check that out. But I mean, I do feel like that was definitely a big change, because both girls really enjoyed it, my youngest in particular. My oldest could take it or leave it, and she's going to be graduating in 2 years anyway, so it's not as huge of a deal. But for my youngest, she is just now finishing fourth grade. She's got a long way to go, and I feel like we definitely need something for her that gives her that classroom experience outside of the home. So I don't know yet what's gonna happen with that. We will see, but that was definitely a big change in this current school year. Okay, so that's pretty much the main changes and updates with my oldest. With my youngest, there aren't as many changes or anything really to report, just a few things, mostly because everything with her has been pretty smooth sailing. I think the main thing that we did, we actually changed between third grade and fourth grade. And if you watched my third grade curriculum choices video, which you may not have, but if you did, you would have seen we were using a particular spelling and vocabulary curriculum. We actually switched for fourth grade. We switched from Spectrum Spelling and Scholastic's 240 words every kid should know, or something like that. We switched from those to Evan Moore's Building Spelling Skills and Evan Moore's A Word a Day for vocabulary and spelling. And so far that switch has been amazing. I like those two workbooks much, much better than what we were using. There was nothing really wrong with what we were using, but it wasn't quite right, if that makes any sense. But both of those Evan Moore workbooks are amazing, and so much so we're actually gonna be using them for fifth grade, which if you have seen my fifth grade curriculum choices video, you would already know we're gonna be doing those again for fifth grade. But I just love them. I can't say enough good things about them. They have been a perfect fit for us for spelling and vocabulary. Sometimes simpler is better. You don't have to have a crazy expensive curriculum for spelling or vocabulary. These workbooks are doing a really good job getting it done, and I feel like she's learning tons of new words, and her spelling has really, really improved since using these books. And also, my youngest just finished her first distance learning curriculum, except for teaching textbooks. Teaching textbooks is both girls' math program, and it's all done online. But there's not a physical teacher standing there. There is someone teaching the lesson, just like a voiceover, and you've got things going on the screen. But both girls actually completed the BJU Press Homeschools history classes. My oldest daughter did world history. My youngest did heritage studies. She actually did heritage studies 3, which is a 1-semester course, but she just finished that and she loved it. She loved her teacher and it was just a really fun experience for her, I think, especially for a subject that I'm not really wild about teaching. And her teacher on with BJU Press Homeschool was really, really energetic and fun and had all these props and things, which made it a lot more fun for her. And she really, really enjoyed those history lessons online with BJU Press Homeschool. But actually both girls are gonna be doing their distance learning online again next school year for history. My youngest is gonna be doing Heritage Studies 4. My oldest is gonna be doing US History. So I love BJU Press. We use them for quite a few subjects. Both girls are doing their history, and then I also teach my youngest their English program and science. So I love them, whether they are the lessons that you teach or the lessons that they watch online with their distance learning. Either way, I think it's a great curriculum. It's really, really thorough, and it has been a great success for both girls. There is actually a sale with BJU Press if you've ever wanted to try it out or you already use it and you're looking for a discount for next school year from May 28th through June 3rd, sale going on. I'll have information for it in the description box if you're interested, but just for those few days. So make sure if you're going to be purchasing anything from BJU Press Homeschool, whether it's their textbooks or their online classes, definitely make sure you do it now where you can get that discount. That's pretty much the only updates and kind of changes that happened with my youngest. Overall, this school year was pretty uneventful until the end. Like I said, we ended up homeschooling a few extra weeks longer just because of quarantine. We were already here anyway, and I felt like, why stop doing school at the end of April like we normally do when we are not even going to be going anywhere in May? Like, normally we school until the end of April and then we're done for the year. We go on vacation to Disney World in May. And then we have a nice long summer. It felt silly to stop at the end of April when we had nowhere to go. And we schooled an extra 2 weeks, which actually we could have done longer than that, but I feel like we were all getting kind of burned out. So those extra 2 weeks are gonna be a little bit of a cushion for us. I don't know yet what we're gonna use them for. We do have a trip to Disney planned in September, but if things don't change significantly, we will either have to cancel or reschedule. If that's the case, I will save those 2 weeks for when we reschedule, or if we end up not going at all in the coming year, I'll use those 2 weeks to either take a longer break for Christmas or something, or finish school next year at the end a little bit earlier. So just kind of waiting. I'm holding on to those 2 weeks just to really see how we're going to use them. But that's definitely been a change for us this year. Like, I always stick to pretty much the same schedule. We're always done by the end of April. So this is the first time we've ever actually done any school in May, and it worked out okay, but it was a rough couple weeks knowing we should have already been done, but we were still doing school. That was a little bit of a challenge. So make sure if you're interested in that editable transcript template download that you email me or message me. You can email me at aplacetonest@gmail.com, or you can just send me a message and tell me you're interested. Basically what I do is you email me and tell me that you're interested, and you can just send me the $10 through PayPal. As soon as I get that, I will email you the editable download for you to use. So trying to make your life a little bit simpler. I wish I'd have had something like this for me when I was going to make the transcript, but it's okay. I don't mind. I actually like creating things, and I really hope it's going to be helpful for you guys to save you guys some time and hassle and headache to make your own transcript. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments some changes, updates, anything that was new or different in your homeschool year. Let me know in the comments. I would be interested to know how your guys' homeschool year went. So leave that for me in the comments. If you're not already, make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.